been dreaming. Cause now that I'm woke, everything that I see, what it seem, man, I guess I've been dreaming. Cause now that I'm here, what I feel motivates me with reason. I guess I've been dreaming.
Peace and love to all the gods and goddesses and all the high vibrating species on the planet. Peace and love to you. Welcome back to the channel. Y'all come on in. Welcome back. You know what I'm talking about? We about to get this thing busting, of course. SCPs, the realm of the monsters, rakes, skinwalkers. We cover all that over here. You know what I'm talking about? And right now we've been in the world of the SCP for real. Like, we've been in here heavy, like, really, really heavy. Salute to all the academates. Come on in. Peace and love to you. You know what I mean? We got disturbance. We got a disturbance over here. It's disruptive. It's a disruptive radix disturbance. I think that may have something to do with radiation, but we're going to find out. Because radiation, depending on its use, can definitely be disruptive and disturbing. We have SCP 6264, and the numerology, yes, we got it, is number 9. You know what I'm saying? When you add those numbers up, you get the number 9, which is the last number on the actual mathematical scale. Number of completion, if you will. So, anywho. Shout it off, get your ace in the back. We ain't trying to hear you. Just get on back there, because you know what I'm saying? Y'all really been messing. Y'all, yeah. Yeah. But anyways, more pressure for that ace. We ain't done with you. You know what I'm talking about? Because I've seen some other SCPs that I'm definitely going to cover. That's along our lines. That I think I need to, you know what I'm saying? Prepare the people for, you know what I'm saying? Give them a little warning, a little heads up or something like that. You know what I mean? Because that's what we're here to do. We're here to warn the people, prepare the people, let the people know the business, whether the people want to believe it or not. It's not going to change the facts of what's to come and what we're here to do, okay? So we're going to do this for the ears that can hear and the eyes that can see, you know what I'm saying? Welcome to Academy 7. I am your host, 7, and this is what we do, and we have incorporated the numerology with it, you know what I'm saying? And we've definitely busting things down all the way to the number, which has proven, we've proven numerology here on this channel time and time again. All right, so that's in a nutshell. We've already proven numerology, and that's why we continue to do it. If we couldn't really pinpoint and hit a lot of stuff, then we probably would have pulled it out. But it works. Not maybe for every single SCP, but for the most part, it works. And, excuse me, for today's numerology, we have number 9, and that's masculine energy, and we haven't had the number 9 in a while, so, you know what I'm saying, that's outside of this scale right here, what we'll be reading, that's 9 ether energy, you know what I'm saying, 9 ether beings, that's the carbonated, neuromelanated beings on the planet, you know what I'm saying, 9 ether energy, that dark matter energy, it's metaphysical, metahuman type when you're dealing with us. All right, so, and that's yet to come. Just stick around. All right, just stick around. So anyway, so the number 9 is masculine in energy, and it's governed by the Mars. So that's Mars energy as well. Aries, and Scorpio. So that's Aries in the first house and Scorpio in the eighth house. So this also harnesses both these energies in those houses. All right. And then for the positive energy, we have a humanitarian. Let's keep going. Generous, energetic, bold, courageous, competitive, strong, inspirational, independent, good organizer, self-determining. Charitable, artistic, resourceful, global-minded, spiritual, strong-willed. All right, so that's some of the positives that correlates with the number nine, and you don't have to have all of those characteristics if you resonate with the number nine, whether that be your birthday, your path number, life path number. You just keep saying nine for your angel number, whatever you subscribe to, right? Anyways, the tidbits. Hold on, so we got some negatives. I'm sorry. Negatives. The negatives here are impulsive, hasty, ill-tempered, cynical, argumentative, over-emotional, daydreaming, flip side, narrow-minded, aimless, heartless, resentful, selfish, all talk and no show. Okay? So, if you find yourself on the negative side of that, we may want to turn that around. You know what I'm talking about? That's just food for thought. You know what I'm saying? Just food for thought. All right? Occupations. And you don't have to have any of these occupations, again, if you resonate with the number nine. All right? So, you know what I'm saying? Just do more your due diligence on the number nine and the energies and the correlations that it has with you. All right? So, pick up what resonates and put down the rest. Occupations. Police. The military officer, a politician, a firefighter, construction worker, a musician, artist. Yeah, okay. Yeah. spiritual leader, publisher, journalist, cutler, okay. What the hell? A surgeon, a steel worker, ballistics expert, a judge, an occultist, a pro athlete, union leader, TV and radio personality, entrepreneur, and a travel expert. And I'm sure there's more, but that's for the nutshell of the tidbits. So that's some of the jobs that you have, occupation, whatnot, or things that you may be interested in, but not necessarily, you know what I'm saying, doing that today for your work. All right, anyway, so the tidbits: the rulership over slaughterhouses, battlefield. Fire in police stations, of course, ammunition plants, armories, auto industry, steel mills, industry, travel industry, international movements, and publishing houses. The colors that it coordinates with is red, rose, and the crimson families. And the tarot, if you're into such a thing, is the hermit card, and that kicks out virtue of prudence, patience, and maturity, as a spiritual light to keep on the right path. Learn caution and vigilance from personal experience. Symbolizes a shift in perception. Okay, so that's again here at Academy 7. We like to bring a different perspective to the SDP universe, and that's what we've done so far. And obviously the way that we've brought it has attracted some shallow people. So that's why at first I really didn't worry about anybody hitting the like, share, and subscribe button. But seeing the fact that we got some people trying to actually block us from getting into the main algorithm, I actually, you know what I'm saying, request that everybody hit the like, share, and subscribe button. But I also tell you, no pressure. And the Academy should tell you, no pressure to do so. But I just ask that you do so. Help me out here. You know what I'm saying? I give y'all information. You know what I'm saying? And, in my perspective, and my energy, and my time, let's kind of make that a fair, even exchange. You know what I'm saying? My energy for your energy. You know what I'm saying? I give you some, you give me some. You feel me? So hitting that like button will take the channel a hell of a lot further than they want us to go. And I'm actually enjoying it. I'm sure the academates are enjoying it. You know what I'm saying? And we've been able to debunk a lot of things and find a lot of stuff that most people probably wouldn't have looked at had we not went over it, and especially bringing numerology to it too as well. So yeah, I'm grateful, and regardless of any of that, so Academates, without I hope you got what you need, because I do. And without further ado, we're gonna get to what it is that we do. If you're new, again, hit the like, share, and subscribe button for me, please, if you will. Bink, you know what I'm talking about. And it's free. Yes sir, it's free, no problems, it's free. And yeah, that's get a bus. Who this is? Hold on. Who this is? Who this is? Because we've been all over the place in channels. Who the channel? Who the channel belong to? Okay, Mr. Creeps, Crypt. So Mr. Creeps, Crypt. Ain't got a logo over here. Nope, obviously. Okay, so this is Mr. Creeps, Crypt. This is his channel. If you're liking his content, whatever, y'all don't forget to slide by and like, share, and subscribe with him or them or her or whoever this may this person, this entity may be. Salute to you. You know what I'm saying? Thank you for the content for me to go over. Hopefully you got something good for me today. This the disturbance is intriguing enough to bring us spinning your block again. You know what I'm talking about? Bless. We got some video game music. Video game. And boy, I promise you, boy, they don't secure a thing.
SCP-6264. Object class, Radix. Special containment procedures. SCP-6264-G and SCP-6264-M are to retain positions at the Foundation, but ensure neither is within the same work environment. However, due to their roles within the Foundation's organizational structure, this is to be heavily encouraged and recommended rather than enforced. As the Foundation Complaints Office is highly aware of SCP-6264, all new complaints regarding the situation are to be immediately discarded. Description: SCP-6264 denotes two SCP Foundation administrative branch members, Charles, Georgia, and Hillary Mullane. Georgia, SCP-6264-G, is the acting director of Site-19, and Mullane, SCP-6264-M, is the current coordinator of the North American Ethics Committee. The two will begin to argue when, within the same work environment, becoming progressively louder and more disruptive. At the argument's climax, multiple anomalous characteristics at varying degrees will manifest in SCP-6264's current work environment. These are as follows: heightened stress in surrounding Foundation staff, increased sensitivity to noise, decreased ability to communicate professionally, raised room temperature, increased humidity, presence of insects, primarily flies and moss, sudden generation of water. SCP-6264 was first discovered when the two instances were assigned to the Site-17 Logistics Department, and the site's administrative staff received more than 142 complaints within 24 hours of the instance's assignment. Addendum 1. An interview between SCP-6264-G and SCP-6264-M and Officer George Parks concerning the nature of the two instances' anomalous attributes, conducted on February 18, 1961. Begin log. Thank you for finding the time to sit with me, sir and miss. Of course.
What the? Oh, okay. Yeah, so we already got over emotional, ill-tempered, and argumentative, you know what I'm saying, on the negative side, just because of whatever this SCP is producing. So obviously it's putting out a low vibratory frequency, which, hence to this color here, is if you were in the room, it would be red. So that's the lowest color, you know what I'm saying, which would on the spectrum, the color spectrum. So we got negative energy here.
Chris, how may I help? Let's make this as brief as possible. I have a meeting in half an hour. Oh, don't worry, coordinator. It shouldn't take long. Well, firstly, I would like to ask about your anomalous attributes. I'm all ears. Isn't that chair a tad small for you, sir? What kind of question is that? Of course not. Moving on. Your anomalous properties manifest when around each other. Do you have any idea why this may occur? Her anomalous properties. I'm sorry? I beg your pardon. I've said this before, they have nothing to do with me. When her anomalous properties finally dared to show themselves, of course, they latched onto me. My presence became the trigger mechanism. I don't fault you for your ignorance. You have no control over your clearance level. But when sapient anomalies manifest abilities they can't control, they usually have an environmental trigger. I was nearby at the time, so her trigger clearly became me. I wasn't aware of this. If I may, Parks, he's full of garbage. Anthro is a G and a snarly mug. I said the anomaly. If the O5 would listen to me, you'd be in containment. Carry on with your questions, Parks. All right. How would you describe your relationship? Non-existent. The only relationship that exists is the negative correlation between the amount of work that I get done and the amount of time that she spends at pestering me. Respectfully, sir, you instigate every fight that you've had. Interesting. I don't remember being the one who used department funds on a petty pissing match. Both of you, please. Director, would you say that you dislike Malayne? No. Of course not, you misunderstand. I do not dislike Malayne. I simply find her presence a nuisance. In a professional sense, she interferes with the efficiency of my management. As site director, mind you. I see. There is nothing worse than inefficiency in our line of work. Let me tell you something. You have the new Site 19 subsidiary site built in a swamp miles from here. What about that?
Hey man, who the boy is there right here, man? So this the royal family right here? The 13 royal family, this some boy right here? The 05 council, this some boy right here, ain't it? I think this some boy right here, but hey, beam up right here. I'm trying to tell you. Oh, it's over. Let me tell you. It's over. You know what I'm saying? We come for that ace. We in here. Come for that ace. We finna shut all this down. You know what I'm saying? But it's all good. Let's continue to go through it. But I'm just. And it's almost looked like a picture I've seen before. And they masonically structured. Yeah, free masonically structured right there. Yeah, you got your three count. Yeah. I'm on it. I see ya.
G rolls his eyes and leans closer to Officer Parks. Between you and I, those ethics committee goons consistently deny any propositions that I put forward. I know for certain they do not read them all. It's a vendetta, I tell you. They'll probably flag this very interview for unsuitable workplace behavior.
Probably.
Of course, I'll delete the report, so you don't need to worry. You don't seriously expect me to keep quiet about what you just said, Charles.
Yeah, they keep the shadow ban on you.
Okay. The complaints
they definitely put the ban on you.
Reports of your workplace. Disharmony, as it were. Do you believe this is related to your anomalous effects? You don't need to sugarcoat things, Parks. Yes, we argue. Yes, she instigates almost all of our disharmonic interactions. It is unrelated to her anomaly. You are such a scumbag. And do you know the significance of your anomalous? Her. I apologize. Do you know the significance of her anomalous effects? For example, I can understand why the room temperature increases. Why personnel have an increased noise sensitivity.
Why is that?
They all seem to be related to the human reaction to stress. But why the increased humidity? Why the flies? Why the water? I don't want to cast aspersions, but maybe George's obsession with swamps has something to do with it.
Excuse me.
I established one site in a swamp, and it's the end of the world for you, huh? Parks, I have no idea. Honestly, I hadn't noticed them until you mentioned them just now. They were very concerned.
I can answer that question. It's negative energy. You said, why the flies? Why the water? Okay, well, first of all, If the temperature is rising in that, then I'm, of course the body, the avatar, some, you know what I'm saying, may start producing an odor, sweating. You know what I'm saying? And that attracts flies and other little type of insects that's into filth, for one. For two, the water changing is definitely negative energy. Yeah, you can speak to the water. Speak positive affirmations into your water, and that water will take on that energy that you spoke into it, that vibration. And then when you drink such waters, it puts that vibration into the body. Like, you can definitely, you know what I'm saying? When, listen, just do your own due diligence. You feel me? Just do your own studies when it comes down to these type of things, because I don't want them saying, I'm not a doctor. I don't have a PhD. You know what I'm talking about? I get down with the science of herbs. You know what I'm saying? I'm an herbalist and stuff like that. I do, you know what I'm saying, delve. But as far as on their paperwork, you know what I'm saying? I don't have a PhD. But I've healed a lot of people, including myself. Bones included. You know what I'm saying? Just studying things. And shout out to Dr. Savior. You know what I'm talking about? That's all I got to say about the situation. You feel? I don't care if you like it or not. And it's just, it is what it is. I ain't here to lie to you. You know what I'm saying? Reading his books and studying up behind him. Yeah. Come to find a lot of things. You know what I'm saying? And it's right there in your backyard type of deal. But yeah, man, this is, we got some stuff. We already got some stuff. We got the color coordinated. We got definitely all the negatives have been coordinated in this thing. But I'm just saying, you know what I'm saying, when it comes to that water making its changes, that's definitely the energies, the negative energies. So yeah, y'all look into that. If you're interested, look into that. You know what I'm saying? Just why, that's what we do encourage over here at Academy 7, that you know what I'm saying, keep your critical thinking on, and that, you know what I'm saying, use your due diligence and your intuition. You know what I'm saying? That's what we do encourage. Anything. Do your own research. Gather your own information. Come to your own conclusion. That's what we promote here. You know what I'm saying? Our perspective is our perspective. What we do is what we do. We ain't asking nobody to do what we do. You know what I'm saying? If it's interesting enough, ask a question or two. I'll point you in the right direction or at least the direction that I went in. You know what I'm saying? Might not necessarily be the right direction for you. Everything ain't for everybody. You feel me? Anyway, I digress. Let's get it. I'm just saying, they just be acting like they don't be knowing stuff.
Intense. I don't think there's anything to worry about. If I haven't noticed the effects, I'm sure they're not of any concern. The cleaning costs are rising significantly due to you two. A fly buzzes past Parks.
Annoying.
He waves his hand at it.
Annoying.
G appears distracted by it. My request to remove Georgia has been denied, Parks. I'm not sure what to do past that. The only time that we aren't in the same building during work hours is when I'm summoned elsewhere. Which doesn't happen often. I wonder why. Was that necessary, Charles? As is, we can't remove Georgia from his position. He excels in his duties and is a great director. Even if you two arguing is causing issues. G sticks his tongue out at M. I would like to bring it to your attention that Site 19's architectural foundations have been sinking into the earth, albeit very slowly. We have reason to believe this corresponds with your arguments. I'm sorry, sinking by how much? Approximately 12.6 centimeters. Though we've noticed this is increasing with each argument. Have you ruled out tectonic activity? This increase is in addition to the daily recorded rates. About 8.6 micrometers. Dear God. If it's that much of a problem, I will have Malayne move to a different site. Excuse you. Site 19 needs me far more than it needs you.
My bad.
The carpeting is becoming a bit moist. To remind you, I outrank you. Absolutely not. My committee could have you removed at a moment's notice. And yet I'm still here. I wonder why that is. Maybe because you don't know how this hierarchy works. The committee can only intervene with my duties if I pose a direct threat to human life.
Hmm.
You both share equivalent ranks. What? Did you not know that? You two don't have jurisdiction over one another. M's mouth is agape. G leaves off his chair and hops out of the room. I need to make some calls. M exits the interview. And log. Following this interview, the Internal Operations Committee filed an appeal to formally separate G and M.
What them boys got going on, bruh? G and M, like, for real, man. What y'all got going on? Y'all sound like two little boys, man. Like, for real. Like, what they got?
for the foreseeable future to prevent the escalation of their anomalous effects. Both instances individually filed complaints against this appeal, which were overruled by an overseer order.
I know, right?
As of writing, G and M have not interacted face-to-face in over 2 years. Addendum 2. A series of actions taken by Site-19's Director's Office and the North American Ethics Committee, respectively, between 1962 and 1964. Each action correlates to an observed effect. It is theorized the actions were a part of a dispute between SCP-6264-G and SCP-6264-M. Action: removal of two foundation front companies for inefficient use of funds. Effect: NA. Action: execution of multiple captured Chaos Insurgency agents. Effect: Site-19 experiences rain for 48 hours. Action: transfer of 120 safe SCP objects from Site-19 to Site-53 as a result of basic humanoid space requirements. Effect: air humidity levels in Site-19 increased to 75%. Action: decommissioning of two Keter-class humanoid anomalies. Effect: Site-19 was declared architecturally unsound due to rising dampness. Action: proposal to place Site-19's acting director on administrative leave for mismanaging site operations and mistreatment of anomalies. Effect: Site-19's west wing is partially subsumed by shifting Earth. Action: use of humanoid anomalies labor in the rebuilding of Site-19's west wing. Effect: wetland environment surrounding Site-19 becomes more pronounced. Action: three ethics committee liaisons placed in Site-19. Effect: Site-19's surrounding area is now classified as a freshwater swamp. Action: ethics committee meeting delayed in favor of O4 court seminar. Effect: Site-19 experiences heavy flooding requiring temporary evacuation. Action: censure of Site-20's acting director for improper workplace behavior. Effect: swampland spreads to Site-24 and Site-180, as well as encompassing multiple towns in the nearby vicinity. Action: anesthetization and release of ethics committee advisor for continually subverting overseer order. Effect: Site-19, Site-24, and Site-180 all flood entirely, causing multiple containment breaches and requiring complete evacuation. Rain has now persisted for 200 hours without stopping.
I tell you what, depending on the facilities or the SCPs that's in the ones that shut down, that's only if that would be a problem. Yeah, I feel me. Like, I'm just saying, if you got like the plague doctor or, you know what I mean, things, anomalies like that, and such, but all they got to do is just touch your, you know what I'm saying, give you a little tap and
blue, blue.
You hit the ground quickly. You feel me? That's maybe able to work through that. You know what I mean? Depending on where y'all stored this thing.
Action. Proposal.
Hey man, why does this picture just look familiar, man? Like I've seen this picture before. Man, is this MJ? Yeah, this may be MJ. Them MJ boys, yeah. I mean, I just feel like I've seen this picture somewhere before, man.
To disband the O4 court to streamline foundation operations. Effect: country.
Have y'all seen this picture before? Let me ask a candidate. If you just happen to slide through and you made it thus far, have you seen the picture before? It looks for this junk looks familiar to me. I don't know why. It just looks familiar. Has anybody seen this photo before? Let me just ask. Drop it below in the comment section if you will. It's a simple yay, maybe, where you think you saw it. You don't have to be right. I'm just saying. I think I've seen it before. I just don't, I'm not sure. But if you have, and you actually know what this photo is, drop it in the comment section, you know what I'm saying? Just let everybody know.
Tree Redacted experiences a tropical cyclone, flooding multiple major cities, rivers, and lakes, and requiring mass evacuation. Foundation operations were placed on red alert. Action: proposal to defund the Ethics Committee due to obsolescence, inefficacy, and embezzling foundation funds for malicious purposes.
Oh, yeah?
Effect: global sea levels were observed to rise by 0.104 millimeters. Approximately 1,200% the average daily sea level increase. To Charles, Georgia at Site 19. From Hillary Mullane at Site 19. Subject: SCP-6264 and us. Dear Charles, this has gone on long enough. We need to put a stop to this. It's unfair to the people around us. I know that I'm not the paragon of morality, but we can't keep hurting them just to keep playing this stupid game. Please think about this and get back to me. I hope you understand. Regards, Hillary. Hello, Hillary. Yes, I know our arguments are causing people pain. I also know that we work for the Foundation. Ergo, it is not my responsibility to babysit people that I have never met and never will meet. I have better things to be doing, like containing anomalies, the greater good and all that. If you really want to help people, here's how you do it. Our anomaly is a two-way system. Therefore, if one of us were to resign from our position and never return, the effects would halt immediately, yes? I myself have an image to maintain, and the last thing that we both want is people finding out. Please think about this.
Yeah, you selfish
bastard. Do not bother getting back to me. I hope that you'll understand. Charles, Georgia, Site 19, and Director's Office. Dear Charles, please reconsider what you're doing. It's not too late to resolve our differences diplomatically. This situation can benefit everyone, even you.
What you trying to do, Shawty?
I will be attending the O4 Court seminar next week on December 4th, and I would very much like to speak to you in person afterward. Please come. Regards, Hillary. Alert. This email has not been delivered for any of the following reasons. Scheduled server maintenance.
Anybody dealing with Hillary, man? We know Hillary.
Please try again later.
Not even Hillary Banks,
nigga. SCP-6264-M resigned from her Ethics Committee Coordinator position and requested a permanent transfer to Site 46, over 2,000 kilometers from Site 19. Immediately after her resignation and transfer were accepted, all previously observed phenomena affecting Site 19 and its surrounding area had ceased. No phenomena have ever been observed since. Addendum 3. On 15-12-64, an anonymous tip was received by the Foundation Complaints Office, accusing SCP-6264-G of abusing his position's power within the Foundation hierarchy.
What do you do?
Corruption, embezzlement, and most notably, impersonation of Foundation personnel. Due to certain classified details included within the report that aligned with Foundation Level 4 documentation, an investigation was commissioned. Moreover, the report specifically requested a member of the Contra Memetics Division conduct the investigation. 1 week later, Memetics agent Thomas Pinman was instructed to arrive at G's office for an interview. G was informed that said interview was part of a routine Foundation security questionnaire regarding the reconstruction of Site 19's West Wing. Pinman's position as a memetics agent was also hidden. The interview can be seen in full below. Begin log. About time, you're late, Pinman. Pinman stands in the doorway looking around the room before spotting G. Take a seat. Pinman looks at G confused. He peers out of the doorway for a moment before pulling out his phone. Hello? After a minute, Pinman looks up at G, an eyebrow raised. Apprehensively, he sits down. Thank you for taking the time to see me. The event has undoubtedly been puzzling to all of us. I'm glad that we can have a professional in the field take a good look at it. Penman stares at G impatiently. He then looks around the room. Can you hear me? Penman looks at G briefly before glancing around the room and diverting his attention to his phone. After a moment, Penman stands up and holds his phone to his ear. Yeah, I don't know where he is. I thought the hotshot director was supposed to be here. The only thing in here is some toad. Hey, sit down. We're in an interview. I don't know what to tell you. He isn't here. Who are you talking to? Are you deaf? Penman looks at G and then back to the door. This dang toad won't stop croaking. I can't seem to find a tank. And does this thing belong to Director Georgia anyways? Are you deaf? Sit down. The person on the other end of the call talks for some time. G continues shouting. Wait, where? Penman looks around anxiously. I'm telling you, he isn't here. Penman looks at G, appearing horrified. Slowly, Penman walks over to G and lowers the phone to his level. Who's this ditz calling? Martha, how are you? How's the wife? Good. Yes, well, I'm not. Yeah, well, you sent me a faulty agent. This bucko has been ignoring me the whole time. It's either your fault or his. Someone's taking responsibility around here, and I don't care who. I'll have him fired if you get that. Well, okay, yes, I understand. I apologize for raising my voice. Those freaks over at HR do get in the way of things. Yeah, yeah. Oh, is that so? Indeed. Yes, yes. No, I haven't heard the news. You would think they would tell me these things considering who I am. But yeah, cool. Penman, confused, sets the phone on the chair beside G and walks over to his seat, slumping into it. 2 minutes of conversation between G and the call recipient had been omitted for brevity. Good to hear, Martha. Have a good weekend. Okay, you too. Hanging up now. G attempts to press the button to disconnect the call, but his finger slips off the glass screen. That's your phone, you do it. G abruptly dismounts from his chair and hops out of the room. Slowly, Penman picks up his phone and brings it to his ear. I think there's something in the water. End log. Following this interview, Penman filed a report addressed to the O5 Council claiming that SCP-6264-G isn't in fact a member of the cane toad species. Despite his refutes, the O5 Council launched a thorough investigation into the matter, as Director Georgia had previously been suspected of malpractice. Penman's report was soon validated, as G has since been removed from his position, being released into Site-24's sentient animal enclosure per Ethics Committee recommendation. Furthermore, M's position on the Ethics Committee was reinstated upon Georgia's dismissal, as her efficiency and adherence to Foundation values, now no longer hindered by the anomaly, are considered of immense value. On 12/11/68, a vote to move SCP-6264-M to Level 5 clearance passed the O5 command, and she has since became a permanent member.
Hey man, that shit was weird as hell, yeah. So, I don't. Listen, I'm thinking it's like, damn, I'm actually left speechless. I don't really know what to say about this one. It's kind of like, what? So what happened again? This thing is doing what again? But at the same time, okay, so what I've gathered, so let's just go over what I gathered so far, you know what I'm talking about, as far as the numerology is concerned, because we was all over the board. Of course, I called out the negative energies that we've seen, exactly what was going on with that. And of course, a lot of that was going on. But then, you know what I'm saying, some of the positive aspects of the number nine popped out as well. The competitive, them being a competitive, energetic, you know what I'm saying, type of deal. Now, Birdie was kind of cold. I don't know what's going on with that. This, and you see, they slipped in this species, this toad species. What is that like the game? Like, what is this? Like the game? The game, y'all look this up. They called the Battle Toads. It was three of them junts. You know what I'm talking about? Three Battle Toads. You know what I mean? And they talking about the toad species. Yeah, I heard you pop that out at the very end. See how they tried to slip that shit in? You know what I'm saying? That's what I was really on. That's like, when I heard that kind of threw the rest of it out. Okay, so what was all the rest of it? So, but obviously this radiates. I'm not necessarily sure if that's completely nuclear or not, you know what I'm saying? Because it seems like over the phone, so they got some radio waves. Then you got this X, so that's the unknown, of course. You know what I'm saying? The unknown, and X is the I think that's nine in numerology as well. So then you had Site 19. You know what I'm saying? Which still refers to like the nine ether, you know what I'm saying? When you like the 19th galaxy, you know what I'm saying? Being a part of all of that, you know what I mean? So it's like, it's a lot of this stuff that's just like, my mind just started going crazy. Like, certain numbers kept popping out. And certain things that they were talking about was just kind of like, okay, I think I know what's going on, but I'm not quite sure exactly who they're talking about. And then all of a sudden they hit you with this toad joint at the very end. Toad species. And the only thing, as soon as I heard that, it's like, first thing I could think about was the battle toads, you know what I'm saying, or some ninja turtles or something, but more so like the battle toads, since y'all talking about an actual toad species. All right, which I played the hell out of that video game. I can't front, you know what I'm saying, that was one of my favorite video games, because them boys, they was with that. It's just like, it's just the ninja turtles, but they some frogs, some toads, excuse me. Some toads, not frogs. Some toads. And yeah, we kicked a lot of hey back, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? When I came up playing that joint back in the day, all right? So yeah, but check that out. It's called Battle Toads, you know what I'm saying? No, they ain't sponsoring me or nothing like that. I'm just throwing that out there, you know what I'm saying? Like I always do when I can think of movies or some type of game or something like that. That was that relates to what we got going on that you could cross reference with. You know what I'm saying? So I don't mind throwing it out there. It's out there. You feel me? Because it don't matter. You know what I'm saying? I'm not the only person that caught it at the time that it came out. So if you catch these things, that's good for you. You know what I'm saying? Try to explain it to the next person so that they're able to catch it as well. Because it's a lot of magic and manipulation and, you know what I'm saying, wool over the eye tricks that's going on. You know what I'm saying? You have to be careful at what you're listening to and what you're watching and paying attention to, what you're giving your energy to. So that's why I try not to waste your time, and I try to actually give y'all some positive energy and things to go by. You know what I'm talking about? Whether you take heat or not, that's what I'm here to do, is to help the planet increase the vibration. Of the planet, continue to rise, continue to help the planet rise, continue to, you know what I'm saying, get myself together and help y'all, you know what I'm saying, remind some of y'all, if you're on that journey, you know what I'm saying, if you fell off foot, to get back up, and we still got work to do, and we're going to keep doing that in whatever facet we need to do that in, you know what I'm saying. So y'all keep y'all head on that swivel out there. Don't forget to keep yourself spiritually, mentally, physically, and emotionally protected, you know what I'm saying, at all times. Critical thinking on at all times. Due diligence on at all times. You know what I'm saying? Don't forget, it's a war for your mind. At all times. You know what I'm saying? At all times. It ain't got to necessarily always be physical. There's so many ways. So many ways that war has been waged upon you. Get into it. You know what I'm saying? Sun Tzu. Know how they work. Know how operations go. You feel me? Until next time. Peace.